The third presenter for today is Dr. Mrs. Saroja Veerapol. She's a lecturer in the Department of Ayurveda Pediatrics, Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo. Her study is on the anti-inflammatory effect of bowel preparation, Sudarshan syrup in stress.
Honorable Chair Member and my dear colleagues, today I am going to make a presentation under the topic of a study on the anti-inflammatory effect of bowel secretion, Sudarshan syrup in uterus. Luckily, this is the third presentation based on the same methodology. I think it is very easy to understand to all of you. So let's move to my outline. I would like to touch the introduction and methodology, research and discussion, conclusion, acknowledgement and preferences. First, let's move to the introduction. Inflammation is a complex biological response of vascular tissues to harmful stimuli such as pathogens, damaged cells or infants. It is a defensive mechanism aimed to remove the injurious stimuli and initiate the tissue's healing process. Then let's move to the introduction of Sudarshan syrup. Before that, I would like to go to the Sudarshan powder. I think some of them heard about the Sudarshan powder, most of them are indigenous doctors here, so I think others I should discuss about the Sudarshan powder. Sudarshan powder is the most effective Ayurvedic preparation widely used in Sri Lanka as well as in India. It has 53 ingredients. Altogether, the main ingredient was the Swadhyaya Chirata at the early beginning of the Ayurvedic treatment. But in Sri Lanka, it presently replaced by the Androcephalus Canicula type here. I have mentioned here, Androcephalus Canicula type main named in focus. Now we use the Androcephalus Canicula in the Sudarshan powder. The powder contains Androcephalus Canicula 50% along with other 52 ingredients. But all together, which is the 53 ingredients together, it's very bitter taste, extremely bitter taste. So it is very difficult to introduce in Sweden. As I am an Ayurvedic pediatrician, I have good experience with that powder, but it is very difficult to introduce to children. So I wanted to convert this powder into syrup. So therefore I converted Sudarshan powder, converted to syrup using beef honey according to the Ayurvedic Mahan Paribhasha. So we can make a consumer friendly Ayurvedic product. After that, we did lot of studies with rats. First we did toxic studies. I want to check whether it is toxic or not. So we did the acute toxicity study first and we did the chronic toxicity study with giving 42 consecutive days drug protect and always we did the histopathological review. So there is no any toxic defective test. Then after that we did the antibiotic effects and antibiotical nociceptive effects and histamine effects. Also the anti-inflammatory effect. It has a good antibiotic, anti-nociceptive, antihistamine and also the anti-inflammatory effect when compared to the controls we have found. So, these patents have been applied for the new production and the bioactivities that we have found is the less. Then, this study, I would like to touch the investigate the anti-inflammatory potential of Sudarshan syrup in uterus. Animals, healthy unused albinos uterus were purchased from Medical Research Institute, Colombo. Then rats were housed under this standardized animal house condition at the Animal House, Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Chittagong. And they had access to food. It means WHO formula, accepted formula, food formula. It means that foods were prepared according to the guideline of the formula. WHO guidelines and what the administration. Then ethical clearance was obtained from the Ethics Review Committee of the Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sri Jayapur. The anti-inflammatory activity of Sudarshan syrup was determining use in the calcium and use for eczema. Let's go through the groups of rats. 32 rats were randomly divided into 4 groups of 8 rats each. Test 1, Sudarshana powder, test 2, Sudarshana syrup, positive control, endomethacin, and negative control, distal wall. First, we measure the initial pore volume of the rats. We mark the rats, left pore, and we measure the initial pore volume using the tachymeter. It is designed to provide a highly useful tool in measurement of the small volume changes. Then, we administer drug using the sonde needle. After 1 hour of drug administration, 0.1 milliliter of 1% calcium suspension in normal saline was injected subcutaneously into the plantar surfaces of the left hind foot. After that, pore volume was measured tachymetrically hourly interval up to 5 hours. Then calculation of the percentage in each, and we use that formula to calculate the percentage in each. All this statistical analysis was done using SPSS, and this is the result that we have calculated using that formula. The percentage inhibition of edema in endomethacin, Sudarshana powder and Sudarshana syrup groups in comparison to the control group. We have to calculate all the percentage inhibition in every hour. Then let's move to the figure. According to that figure, the red color in the endomethacin, at the first hour, the second hour, endomethacin, the percentage of inhibition is somewhat reduced, decreased, and after the third hour it is increased. But in Sudarshana powder and Sudarshana syrup, it's gradually first hour to up to third hour, it's gradually increased that inhibition. So the maximum inhibition was in the test cup and others also in fifth hour. So the maximum inhibition, 88.5% was noted after 5th hour on the test drug, whereas the indomethacin had 96.2% inhibition. The statistically significant reduction, it means p-value, 0.05, in edema was noted at the hourly, every hour when we compare with the negative control group. Means the distilled water group. The reference drugs also, indomethacin also showed significant inhibition up to 5th hour. Then pattern of inhibition of Sudarshana powder and Sudarshana syrup was similar to that of the indomethacin. So, it can be concluded. The novel preparation, Sudarshana syrup, possessed statistically significant anti-inflammatory effects comparable to the indomethacin and Sudarshana powder. So that powder has it has shown lots of effects. It means the antipyretic, anti-inflammatory, antihistamine, and also the anti-obstructive effects. So further studies are being planned to evaluate the effects in humans. So I would like to take this opportunity to offer my grateful thanks the grant that supported me, the Human Resource Development Program, HRDC project. So these are my references. And thank you all. Thank you very much. Thank you.
so you have made your syrup in honeybee, isn't it? Have you tested the honeybee because that was missing from your control side? But the major issue, I think, related to powder, you have mentioned regarding their taste. Okay. So what I would recommend to just run a survey by the distribution of that syrup to the large number of people and record the taste rank. It would be strategically very useful to add some value in your syrup when you want to apply. Or you can also use an electric tongue to characterize the taste, whether it is visible for the human or not, especially for your patent application. Okay.
Thank you very much for this. Yes, here I use the 8 reps per image. But normally in the studies, previous studies, they use minimum number of 6. So I think it's much better to use 6-8 reps in this study.
That you are trying to develop and see the effective ones, certain anti-inflammatory reactions and so on and so forth, and market it that way someday. And market this. Now, well, some people could do that, and also, I don't know, in US, of course, there are quite a number of things have gone into it, material, you know, but also other scientists also try to separate out and as being said by the chairperson, you try to identify the active ingredient or ingredients. That's another aspect of the study. Then that can go, you know, further up, and you know, with many studies thereafter, we can isolate and make a very specific drug. Well, that's well. I don't know where. So you know. So you are halfway through.
I have planned to do the isolation studies, and this is the main thing I want to do. I have good experience with that powder, so I wanted to prepare same powder without taking any extraction. So that is why I prepared these drugs using this one. But in my PhD studies, there is the another objective is the isolation part. So I think I can make any develop it.
In the absence of any other questions.